us.
Hi everybody, and welcome to It's Virtually Christmas. We've got some great Christmas songs for you today.
We've got a visit from Father Christmas.
And we've got a Christmas story time.
We've got a special message for a special daddy and a special granddad.
And we've got some more surprises for you.
And we just want to say a big thank you to all our volunteers that run the group through the year, and the Toddler group and the Sparkles group. And also for today, big thank you to our lovely band and to Andrew for helping us with the music. Thank you.
Well, let's get started. Have fun and have a wonderful and happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
We're gonna dance, lift our hands, celebrate it's Christmas. Light up the world, Jesus is born. Oh, raise your voice, make some noise, it's Christmas. Let's celebrate and shout for joy. There's a reason why we sing and why we celebrate. Christmas time, yeah, it's Christmas time. It's the season that he's given us a gift so great. It's Christmas time, yeah, it's Christmas time. He's the light of the world, come down to us. From heaven, now everyone sing. We're gonna dance, lift our hands, celebrate. It's Christmas, light of the world, Jesus is born. A gift so great. It's Christmas time, yeah, it's Christmas time. He's the light of the world, come down to us. From heaven, now everyone sing. We're gonna dance, lift our hands, celebrate. It's Christmas, light of the world, Jesus is born.
Excited and thinking about Christmas. I am. I've had loads of letters from little boys and girls telling me what they want for Christmas. And my elves are working really hard to try and get all the toys made in time. But we will, and I'll be there. So look forward to it. And be good, and listen to Mummy and Daddy, and do what you're told. And then we'll have a great Christmas. And don't forget, when I come to your house, leave me a mince pie and leave me a carrot for my friend Rudolph. I've got a carrot here for him now. I'm just going to go and feed it to him. So let's have a happy Christmas. Goodbye and God bless.
Hello boys and girls, today I'm going to tell you a story about the very first time Christmas ever happened.
And it all started with somebody called Mary. Mary lived in a town called Nazareth, a very, very long way away. And one day, an angel came to visit her. I think Mary must have been very surprised and maybe a little bit scared at first. But the angel said to her, "Don't worry, Mary. I've come to tell you that you're going to have a baby."
"Wow, how can I have a baby?" said Mary. "That can't be happening to me."
The angel said, "Don't worry, Mary. You will have a son. And he will be the son of the Most High God. And when he is born, his name will be called Jesus."
"Wow.
Okay then," said Mary. And so she said bye-bye to the angel. And the angel said, "Bye, Mary." And off she went. Now, Mary had a boyfriend, and his name was Joseph. And he was a bit sad, so an angel came to see him too. And the angel said to him, "Hi, Joseph." I think Joseph must have been a bit surprised too. But the angel said to Joseph, "Don't worry, Joseph. Mary's going to have a baby. And when he is born, he must call him Jesus. He is going to be the Son of God himself."
"Oh, okay then," said Joseph. "That's a bit exciting."
And so the angel said, "Bye-bye, Joseph." And off the angel went. One day in Nazareth, Joseph came to Mary and he said, "Come on, Mary, we've got to go to Bethlehem for something called a census. Bethlehem is where my family live. Let's get our things packed up onto our donkey and we can make a start. We've got a very long journey to do and it's a very long way to go. And we don't want to rush because you're soon going to be having a baby." So they packed up their donkey and all their things and off they went. Just like that. It was going to be a very, very long trip. There they are, and Joseph helped Mary, and on they went. Very soon, they arrived in Bethlehem. It was a big town, and there were lots of people there, and there was nowhere for them to stay. But one kind person says, "You can have a stay in the stable. It's just round the back, and I'm sure you'll be very comfortable." "Oh, thank goodness for that," said Joseph and Mary. So off they went to find the stable. A long way away in a faraway land lived three wise magi kings. They were very clever and they used to study the stars in the sky to see what they could find out. And one day, they saw some very special things in the heavens and the stars above. And they said, There's going to be a new king born in Bethlehem. That's going to be very exciting. We must go and see if we can find this new king. So there's all our kings. There they are, looking up at the stars. And so they said, well, we must get packed because we've got a long journey to go on. It's going to take us a long time and we'll have to take our camels to carry everything for us as well. And so they went back to their palaces to pack all their things up and get ready for their long journey. Just like that. And here's some of their camels. Don't they look fantastic? I think they're going to have to carry a lot of luggage for the wise Magi kings, aren't they? And off they set on their journey. Mary and Joseph arrived at the stable at last. When they got there, they found it was full of animals, all different kinds. There were some cows and sheep and goats, lots of different animals for them to share with. That was nice. But the animals made room for Mary and Joseph. There they are, so they unpacked all their things. I think they might have given their donkey something to eat and drink. And before long, Mary gave birth to a baby boy called Jesus. There's Mary with baby Jesus. Isn't that lovely? And she laid him down in the manger, which was actually an animal's feeding bowl, on a bed of hay, and wrapped him up in nice warm clothes to make him comfortable and looked after him. I think baby Jesus was very happy. Mary and Joseph must have been so happy. Nearby, around Bethlehem, there were lots of fields, and in the fields were lots of sheep looked after by shepherds. The shepherds looked after the sheep while they were feeding on the grass to keep them safe from all the wild animals. The shepherds were very poor people, and they worked very, very hard looking after their sheep. And so they must have been very, very excited one day when all of a sudden, up in the sky, they heard some angels singing. Wow, what a special day that was. Here they are. Here's the shepherds and all their sheep. Together, nice and safe, on the hillside. Let's bring some more sheep in, shall we? That's it. Lots and lots of sheep they had to look after. There they are, all the shepherds and all the sheep. Safely gathered together. I wonder what it was like when they heard in the sky the sound of angels singing. Here they come. There were lots of angels in the sky. A heavenly host. and they were singing and praising God, and they said to the shepherds, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to all you shepherds looking after your sheep, doing such a good job. There's a new king. God himself is born in Bethlehem." That was such great news from the angels, a new baby king. The angels said, "You must go and visit him. Look for the star. Follow the star, and you will find it coming to rest on the baby Jesus." "Wow, that's so exciting," said the shepherds. "Bye-bye," said the angels. So off they went. They gathered their sheep up together and they ran off into Bethlehem to see if they could find the new baby king. And they followed the star with their sheep. There they go. Off they go, looking for the stable and the baby Jesus. When they got there, they were so amazed. It was God himself. And they bowed down and worshipped him because he was so special. There they are. That's the shepherds with all their sheep come to worship baby Jesus. Then along came the wise Magi kings. They must have been tired after their long journey, but they were so pleased and amazed to find the baby Jesus. They brought him presents, some presents of gold and frankincense and myrrh. "Behold, the Lamb of God, God himself, born among us, born to take away the sins of the world." Let's all worship baby Jesus. What an amazing story. Happy Christmas, everybody.
Hi Sparkles, we've got a lovely easy craft for you today where you're going to make baby Jesus lying in his manger. Now, mums and dads will help you with this, I'm sure. Now you need a bit of paper and you need to cut it into kind of a square. Doesn't need to be exact. You'll see why in a minute. And nothing I ever do is exact. Right, there we are. Now, once you've got your square of paper, take a 2p coin and draw around it. That's going to be for baby Jesus's face. There we are. And then we'll give him some lovely closed sleepy eyes and a lovely smile. There we go. Now, to do his blanket, all we need to do is some lovely lines up and down the paper, just like that. And if you are very clever, boys and girls, then maybe you could colour his blanket in. I'm just going to leave it white, but I'm sure you're all far cleverer than I am. There we are. Wonderful. Now, to turn this square into a little baby Jesus, you need to just roll it round and get your sellotape. There we go. Stick it down at one end. And then stick it down at the other end. There we are. Okay. Now, you get a little pot like this takeaway one or something similar, or even a saucer. And then if you've got some paper, it can be yellow, it can be any colour at all, something like this brown paper bag, just cut some strips that are going to look like the nice comfortable hay that baby Jesus was laying in the manger. There we go. And then just little strips of hay for the baby's bedding to keep them all nice and comfortable and warm in there. Right, now put all your lovely hay together in your manger. And then you can lie your baby Jesus in there. Enjoy.
I miss you, Daddy. I love you. Daddy, Uncle Andrew, Grandma and Grandpa.
We miss you.
Merry
Christmas.
Merry Christmas. I hope Grandpa get better soon. I love you all. I hope you're all okay.
I'll see you soon, Daddy.
See you soon, Daddy. I only had two Christmases.
Merry Christmas.
I love you, but also too high.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for sending your son Jesus as a baby. We thank you too for our wonderful Sparkles group and for all the wonderful children who've taken part today to make it such a special nativity. We pray too for all their families, and we pray especially for their granddad who's poorly, and we wish a speedy recovery upon him, Lord. Lord, we thank you too for our wider church family and for our church leaders. Lord, we are so very grateful for our volunteers, the lovely ladies who run our toddler group and our Sparkles group. As we come to the close of such a hard year for everyone, we pray you will stay close to all of us and keep us all safe and well. Lord, we thank you so much for our amazing key workers
who have gone the extra mile this year, and for the wonderful scientists who have been busy developing a vaccine to keep us all safe. Lord, as we approach Christmas, we pray that each member will be filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, and the peace of the Christ child. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.
We hope you've all enjoyed our sparkles. It's virtually Christmas today.
Yep, we've had a great time sharing with you all.
And boys and girls, don't forget, carry on being good and leave that mince pie out for Father Christmas.
And a carrot for Rudolph too.
Yes, very important. And now we just want to wish you all a very happy Christmas. Bye.
Bye everybody.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight.
Happy Christmas, everybody. I miss you. I miss you. See you next year. Happy Christmas.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. Next year all our troubles will be miles away.
Hello, boys and girls, mums and dads. I hope you are all keeping well, and I'm wishing you a very happy, safe Christmas.
And girls of Sparkles and mums and dads. I miss coming up and seeing you a lot, but I hope you all have a very happy Christmas and look forward to meeting up with you in the new year.
Fates allow until...
Merry Christmas, boys and girls, and a happy and a healthy new year.
Happy Christmas, everyone.
We hope you have a great Christmas and a happy new year. Bye. Bye.